Good evening, you're watching NewsX, I'm Ritanshu Bhattacharya. The Supreme Court had mandated last month that cinema halls have to play the national anthem at every screening and had asked the audience to stand in respect. However, in a dramatic turn of events in Chennai, moviegoers have been left shocked because a group was thrashed at a local mall after they refused to get up for the national anthem before the screening of a Tamil movie. The violence broke out during the intermission of a show. Witnesses said that 9 people had remained seated while the anthem was being played. The incident has reignited a debate on vigilante justice and hooliganism.
Yes, and Tamil Nadu has had this problem. The Dravidian movement was a secessionist movement, and this disrespect for everything Indian is a culture of some of these rowdy elements in Tamil Nadu who have been ruling the roost. It's now they must be shown their place. And if the government doesn't take action, then it means Article 356 has to be invoked. Whether we think that the judgment is right or not, the fact is the Supreme Court has given that judgment, and it's about the national flag, and they must obey it or challenge it.
See, once it has become a kind of a binding law, then you can't defy it, although you may disagree. And there are, of course, have been certain voices that were raised after this verdict, that you can't just try to foist the patriotism into somebody. It should come from within. And then now these controversial incidents would go on occurring. Some people may play some mischief. Some people may show some disrespect by not only not standing, but creating some noise or something of that kind, and then doors to be shut, etc., or not bolted. You know, unnecessary this controversy has risen.
The Supreme Court judgment came to the surprise of many, in the sense that, you know, whether these decisions are to be taken by the Supreme Court or by the government, we do not have a final answer on that. But the basic question is that in the cinema theatres, after the cinema, we know that how people are in a hurry to leave the theatre and all, you know. So playing national anthem and people showing disrespect to national anthem should be dealt with strongly, no doubt about that. But the decision of the Supreme Court, whether it can be implemented in the true spirit, respecting the national anthem, is a matter of big worry to everybody.
Well, the Supreme Court's ruling now stands set in stone, but are there enough guarantees in place to ensure that if you do break the law by not standing, you will be booked according to the law and not be at the receiving end? Of the mercy of vigilance. Now, keeping that in mind, let's open it out to our reporters who are joining us from cinema halls across the country. We are being joined by Jay Prakash from Bengaluru, from Rahul from New Delhi, and Shyam Sundar, who's joining us from Patna. We're also inviting you, our viewers, to call us and give us your views on this raging debate. Let's go across first to Jay Prakash, who's joining us from Bengaluru. Jay Prakash, what do people in the Bangalore have to say? Now, there is one separate debate as to whether patriotism, or at least a display of patriotism, should be made mandatory or not. But the fact is that it has been done so by the Supreme Court. But of course, these concerns remain over whether people who default and not obey the law, how exactly should they be dealt with?
Yeah, basically, we're getting mixed response when it comes to playing national anthem at the beginning of the movies. Well, while some say that, you know, it's an opportunity thrown at people to show their patriotism, some go on to say that, in fact, you know, if you're forcing it on people, you're giving an opportunity for some kind of discord in the theatres before the movies play out, because everybody, you know, don't behave in a certain fashion or a manner when they come to watch a movie. In fact, we are joined by some movie buffs and also a manager of the theatre. We are at this Everest theatre, which is 80-year-old theatre in Bangalore, very old one, which is right now playing a Hindi movie. Yeah, what do you have to say about this new rule?
I myself gave due respect while listening to national anthem, but moreover, in the other case, when it is national anthem being forcefully played in the theatre, you might have observed that almost every people, in some regards, some of them don't give due respect to listening to national anthem. So it itself is creating a platform for some of the person to disrespect the national anthem. That's my opinion. Thank you.
Well, as he says that, you know, it gives an opportunity for these hooligans or any elements who don't, you know, have patriotism or show patriotism in the right manner. We're now joined by the manager who's been playing this, who's been organizing this for some time. What does he have to say about it?
Sir, I prefer once we play the national anthem in the screen, single screen, or whether it is multiplex, people have to respect the national anthem. They have to stand in attention. If some sitting, some standing, there is no respect in that. That is the thing. That is my opinion too.
But Jairaj, could you ask the manager of that cinema feels about when vigilantes take the law into their own hands? You know, if there are a group of people who do not show a stand up for the national anthem and flout the SC rule, the theatre has all the freedom to file a police complaint against them. But can they really support a group of hooligans going, taking the law into their own hands and beating up these defaulters?
The main pertinent question is, yes, if hooligans are there, yes, they take create scenes here,
yes,
what from a theater perspective, yeah, what do you have to do? Will you file an FIR? How will you control them?
So all? Actually, no, we have to tell them, we have to teach them. See, everybody doesn't know how to respect the national anthem. If we teach them, automatically they learn. First thing, we have to respect the national anthem.
The group of people and create ruckus here.
Yes, yes.
How do you
we have to
them?
Cooperate. No, we have to cooperate. We have to tell everything. So that we have to make them cool.
So he says they have to explain
well,
the
of
situation
course it
and
is.
Calm.
He, well, Jairaj, interestingly, was quite ambivalent as to how exactly patriotism has to be taught to people. Nevertheless, I'll come to you also, Shyam Sundar, Android P, and Rahul P. Stay on with me. Let's go across to the first of our callers. You have Shankar joining us from Mysore and Saroj joining us from Delhi. Saroj, go ahead and have your say.
Okay, yeah, I do think it's disgraceful for these people not to be respecting the national anthem. I mean, for example, our little children, even when there's a movie or something, when the national anthem is played, even our little children stand up. But then I think these people might be taking the examples from what's happening around the country. For example, the parliament. Or, for example, this guy, I won't even call him a minister, from West Bengal, who was talking about the CM, Mamata Banerjee, by pulling her hair. So what do you do with people like that? I think they should also be thrashed. Thank you, my dear.
Thank you, Saroj, for joining us with your views. Let's also go across to Rahul, who's joining us from National Capital. Rahul, how do people in Delhi view, A, not just the Supreme Court's ruling, but also the ways in which there are concerns, of course, of vigilantism and hooligans deciding who exactly is showing respect and who is showing disrespect to the national anthem?
Well, right now we are standing in Connaught Place, which is in the heart of national capital. Here outside Odeon multiplex. Let's talk to some people and get a reaction as to what do they think about the Supreme Court ruling, which is mandated that all people must stand in cinema hall while the national anthem would be played. The Supreme Court has mandated that all people must stand when the national anthem would be played before the screening of the movie. Do you welcome this order?
Actually, I feel that patriotism cannot be forced upon someone. If you respect your country, patriotism cannot be forced upon someone. If you respect your country, it should come from within. And I don't think it should be forced upon someone, actually. That's on the one hand. And on the other hand, as for me, whenever I hear the national anthem playing anywhere, if I'm around, automatically I stand up. It's something that, as I told you, it comes from within. And you should not get beaten up for not standing up. Maybe they were busy on their phones. It might be the case. So I can't take any side here. I don't know the exact scenario what happened here.
So people are welcoming the move. However, they're saying that a patriot is something which comes from inside and it's.
Let's go across to callers who are joining us as well. Shankar, if I'm not mistaken, joins us from Mysore. Shankar, if you're still with us, please go ahead and have your say.
Yeah, the thing is, I just want to say, like, we stand in our lives for many occasions. Like, we stand in a chai corner, we stand in a restaurant, and I don't feel it's a big matter to stand a minute and a half or 2 minutes for the national anthem.
Yes, indeed. But if you, but if there is somebody who does not feel the same level of patriotism, is it fair to beat him up?
No, beating. So nobody should take hands in the law. That's my opinion. But the thing is, how can we say that you cannot stand for national anthem? We stand in many queues. We stand in railway counter. We stand in many counters. To it's hardly 2 minutes.
All right. Thanks a lot, sir, Shankar, for joining us with your views. Let's go across to Shyam Sundar, joining us from Patna. Shyam, the prevailing view of our viewers who are joining us on the phone line as well as joining our colleagues as well is the fact that while patriotism is absolutely a given and there should not be seen as a burden to stand up for the national anthem for 52 seconds, no one really has the right to take the law into their own hands and force somebody to show patriotism by beating that person up. And that clearly is something which is absolutely uncalled for. What do people in Patna think?
Well, yes, Sutanshu, we are at the Regent Cinema Hall here in Patna, and we'll directly talk to the people here as to what they think about it. Sir, just tell me that the Supreme Court has mandated it that you need to stand before when the national anthem is played in cinema halls. Now, do you support this move of the Supreme Court?
Yes.
Kya aap support karte hain Supreme Court case ko?
सपोर्ट करते हैं
आप बताइएगा सर सुप्रीम कोर्ट ने जो नियम लगाया है कि अब फिल्म्स के पहले नेशनल एंथम होगा तो डू यू सपोर्ट दिस मूव
या वी एक्चुअली सपोर्ट दिस थिंग्स इट्स ये बिल्कुल अच्छा कदम होगा एक्चुअली जब तक हमें ये ऐसा नहीं करेंगे तब तक हम अपने देश के प्रति कैसे दिखा पाएंगे कि हम
लेकिन चेन्नई में एन इंसिडेंट हैज कम टू लाइट वेयर फ्यू पीपल वर बीटन अप बाय अदर्स बिकॉज दे डिड नॉट स्टैंड अप इट वाज सेड दैट दे वर क्लिकिंग सेल्फीज एंड ऑल दिस सो इस टाइप ऑफ विजिलेंटिज्म डू यू सपोर्ट दिस टाइप ऑफ होलीगनिज्म इन द नेम ऑफ पेट्रियटिज्म
इट विल कम स्लोली Actually, just with a single move, you cannot control the whole country. It will come from within. It has to come from within. By beating other people, you cannot do these things.
Well, there are many more people here. We'll also try and talk to them and get to know as to what they think about it. Sir, ye batayega jo Supreme Court ne ye kaha hai ki film ke pehle jo national anthem bajega. Kya do you support this move?
Support ye galat hai. Film hall mein achhi bhi film chalti hai, kharab bhi film chalti hai. Parantu ye hona chahiye, lekin nahi hai. Galat hai.
और चेन्नई में एक इंसिडेंट आया है जहां कुछ लोगों की पिटाई कर दी क्योंकि वो खड़े नहीं हुए थे तो क्या इस तरीके का राष्ट्र देशभक्ति आप सपोर्ट करते हैं
ये हाँ उनके ये गलत है
क्या गलत है?
उनको खड़ा होना चाहिए था उनके गाने पे राष्ट्रभक्ति है भाई देश का गाना है उसमें क्या है खड़े होने में क्या जाता है किसी का क्या बिगड़ जाएगा
लेकिन जो फिल्म के पहले जो गाना बज रहा है क्या आप उस चीज को सपोर्ट करते हैं
हाँ सपोर्ट करना जरूरी है
Well, there are few women here who've come to watch film. Come here, young. Do you support this move of Supreme Court, which said that the national anthem will be played before this film is screened on air or in cinemas hall? Do you support this?
Yeah. आई सपोर्ट क्योंकि बेसिकली अभी बहुत कम लोग होते हैं नेशनल एंथम जब अगस्त में ही या 26 जनवरी में ही बजते हैं लेकिन अगर हर सिनेमा के मतलब स्टार्टिंग में और मेरे ख्याल से अगर एंडिंग में तो लोग चले जाते हैं स्टार्टिंग में बजना ही बजना चाहिए नेशनल एंथम जब अगस्त में ही या 26 जनवरी में ही बजते हैं लेकिन अगर हर सिनेमा के मतलब स्टार्टिंग में और मेरे ख्याल से अगर एंडिंग में तो लोग चले जाते हैं स्टार्टिंग में बजना ही बजना चाहिए क्योंकि इससे हमारे कल्चर मतलब जो कल्चर पुराने जमाने से आ रहा है लेकिन वो अभी कहीं ना कहीं हमारे इस नेशनल को लेके सब बहुत लोग
लेकिन चेन्नई में एक इंसिडेंट आया है जहां कुछ लोग खड़े नहीं हुए तो कुछ लोगों ने उनकी पिटाई कर दी तो क्या इस तरीके का पेट्रियटिज्म या देशभक्ति क्या ये जायज है इस तरीके का जबरदस्ती किसी को
नहीं नहीं जबरदस्ती जायज नहीं है लेकिन आप हर एक ह्यूमन बीइंग को जैसे कि आज भी यहाँ नेशनल एंथम था मैं ऐसे पांव की थी मैं स्टक हो गई लेकिन आपके अंदर इनर से आना चाहिए कोई चीज आप पे फोर्सफुली डाली नहीं जा सकती अगर कोई ऐसा नहीं मानता है तो ये कोई जरूरी नहीं कि आप उसको पिटाई करें
आप बताइएगा सर जिस तरीके से अब नेशनल एंथम बज रहे हैं सिनेमा हॉल से क्या इस मूव को आप लोग सही मानते हैं जो भी फिल्म
देखिए निश्चित तौर पर राष्ट्र से बड़ा कुछ भी नहीं है हर नागरिक का कर्तव्य है कि राष्ट्र का सम्मान करे राष्ट्रगान का सम्मान करे उस लिहाज से बड़ी अच्छी ये कोशिश है और मुझे लगता है कि हर किसी को सम्मान में खड़े होना चाहिए लेकिन जोर जबरदस्ती भी ठीक नहीं है उनको कोशिश करनी चाहिए प्यार से इस बात को समझें कि राष्ट्रगान राष्ट्र का सम्मान है और उसके सम्मान में खड़े होना चाहिए दिव्यांगों को छूट मिली है ये भी बहुत अच्छी कोशिश है भाई जो नहीं खड़े हो सकते तो उनको मिलनी चाहिए छूट लेकिन मुझे लगता है जबरदस्ती मारपीट भी ठीक नहीं है और मुझे लगता है कि ये नहीं होना चाहिए
So, well, a mixed reaction coming in from Patna. People welcoming this step, saying that yes, if national anthem is played before the film is screened, so there's nothing bad in it. But yes, forced patriotism should not be the case as what happened in Chennai. People said that there should not be a forced vigilantism which happened in Chennai where the few people were beaten up. So people definitely welcoming this step. Say a young lady even said that there's nothing wrong if a national anthem is played even after this film ends. So there's nothing wrong in it, and people should stand up. That is what the people of Patna think about it. Ratanshu.
All right, Shyam, thanks a lot for getting us all those updates. Stay on with us. Let's also go across to Gerald, who's joining us from Mysore on the phone line. Gerald, go ahead and have your say.
Yeah, it's regarding respect to the national anthem.
Yes,
it's a must. But who enforces the rule? It should be the law enforcing authorities. What is the status of this vigilante? Supreme Court should explain the status of vigilante also. If vigilante has to be, they also has to be punished. They cannot enforce the rule which has been made by the Supreme Court or the government. Secondly, in the past, several times, big politicians, including some ex-chief minister, had disrespected. What punishment has been given to them? Whether the Supreme Court has suo motu said that that person, I know very well that I think former chief minister of Bihar had disrespected and no punishment was given. It's only the media made it, showed it that they have shown the disrespect.
Well, thanks indeed, Gerald, for putting it up so properly and succinctly for our viewers. Let's take one last caller before we move on to other stories. BP Pandey joins us from Gurugram. Mr. Pandey, please go ahead and have your say.
Hello.
Yes, Mr. BP Pandey, please go ahead and have your say, sir.
Hello.
Yes, please go ahead. We can hear you.
See, there is no force or non-force patriotism. Patriotism is patriotism, okay?
Okay.
And that should be obeyed. That should be respected.
All right. Thanks a lot, Mr. BP Pandey, for joining us with your views at this point. Thanks also for our colleagues joining us, Jay Shankar, Rahul and Shamsundar, for joining us with those updates from across the country. For now, let's take a quick